Hello, my name is Svetlana, and I'm glad to welcome you at the official channel of the Department of Moscow Cultural Heritage. I'm working at the Tourist Information Office, and I'm also a tour guide. So today I'm going to talk about one of the major sightseeing places of Moscow, which is called the Exhibition of Achievements of the National Economy. This place has no analogs in the world, and it's important that it has been recognized as the National Heritage of Russia. So we begin with the major questions. What is VDNH and what makes it one of the unique places in the world? So VDNH is not only a museum and exposition center, it's also educational and recreational complex, the largest in Russia and one of the largest in the world. Its total area is more than 300 hectares, including Botanical Garden and Ostankino Park. These three parks were recently united in one big park area. There are a lot of attractions at VDNH, and 49 of them were recognized as the National Heritage and protected by the government. VDNH is also one of the favorite public spaces in Moscow, with lots of cultural and business events. So each year it is visited by more than 30 million people. So this is a map of the complex, and according to the new development plan, the entire territory is divided into different themed zones. And today we are going to talk about the central area, which is a historical area of the park, and the landscape park, which is a green area with beautiful ponds and gardens. But we also have Park of Crafts with lots of public workshops, educational center and expo center for international exhibitions, business events and conferences. So it's very important to say a few words about the history of VDNH, which is extremely interesting and dates back to 1939, when the first All-Union Agricultural Exhibition was established. The first exhibition was only agricultural, and it was important to demonstrate achievements in agriculture sector as the positive result of collectivization process. In the end of 30s, the active phase of collectivization was completed and a new socialist collective farms were formed. The collective farm is called kolkhoz in Russian. So the exhibition became one of the powerful instrument of the Soviet propaganda, and its main target was to show all those changes and to present a new Soviet village in a very inspiring and motivating way. Another important idea was to present all republics of USSR, so each republic got its particular building to demonstrate achievements and culture. Russian Socialist Republic was presented by different zonal and regional pavilions, for example, Pavolgia, the Urals, Siberia. There were also pavilions dedicated to specific spheres of agriculture, for example, cattle breeding, beekeeping, vegetable growing, and many others. So you can see some historical photographs. This is a general plan of the exhibition of 1939 and Mechanization Square view with the monument of Stalin. On the 1st of August 1939, the exhibition was opened for visitors, and you can see crowded square in front of the central pavilion, which is decorated with flags and the emblem of USSR. There is also a tower with a sculpture on top of it. This sculpture depicts man and woman, tractor driver and farmer girl, and this is a symbol of the first agriculture exhibition. The sculpture references to another famous monumental work, The Worker and Kolkhoz Woman by Vera Mukhina. It was brought from Paris Expo 37 and installed not far from the exhibition main entrance. After the World War II, the Soviet government decided to revive the exhibition and to enlarge its territory. So it was reconstructed and got its modern, very pompous and pompous design. So here are some historical photographs from the construction period and from the opening of the exhibition on the 1st of August 1954. You can see Collective Farm Square, which is the main square of the exhibition, with the main attraction, the fountain, Friendship of Nations, and all historical Republican and zonal pavilions around it. In 1959, All Union Agriculture Exhibition was renamed the Exhibition of Achievements of the National Economy, and new expositions dedicated to different industries were installed inside of the Republican pavilions. So this caused to a reconstruction, and some of the historical facades were covered with modern but less expressive and sometimes less beautiful fake facades. For example, Pavolgia was transformed into radio electronics, and Azerbaijan pavilion became electronic technologies and informatics. Unfortunately, a lot of original decorative elements and sculptures were damaged or even lost. Middle of 80s was a time of changing political and economical spheres of our country. It was also a time of publicity and a sense of euphoria in the society, but the exhibition almost lost its financing from the government, and the administration had to find new sources of financial support. So the decision was made to lease all rentable spaces, including historical pavilions, and exhibition turned into a giant marketplace. Here are some historical images showing that period of time, and you can see a lot of small shops inside of the historical pavilions and a real market at the territory of the exhibition. Just before USSR collapsed, VDNH was transformed into a state joint stock company under the name All Russian Exposition Center. In 2014, the Moscow government launched a large-scale project to revive VDNH. So enormous restoration work has been done on 24 objects, and 16 of them were fully restored. After the restoration, we finally can admire masterpieces of VDNH, and I've selected some of the most interesting of them. So most of the visitors enter the exhibition through the main arch, which is 32 meters height construction, designed as a triumph arch, which is a symbol of a war victory. But it's also decorated with the images of different agriculture plants and men and women of different professions, which references to the first agriculture exhibition. The arch is crowned with a sculpture. It's a tractor driver and kolkhoz girl, a farmer girl, and they're holding sheaf about their heads and aspiring to the bright Soviet future. Though it looks gilded or golden, it's actually made of concrete and decorated with small pieces of golden smalt. And here are some close-up pictures where you can see pieces of smalt. They have different shades of golden and placed in different directions, so it makes the entire sculpture and especially folds of clothing looks more dynamic and more realistic. The central alley is heading you to the main pavilion, which is the highest historical building and architectural dominant of the exhibition. Its total height with the spire is 90 meters, and it's crowned with the star, which is 6 meters in diameter. It was designed and built in Russian classic style and decorated with colonnade reliefs and sculptures. The emblem of USSR flags and fanfares are covered with golden smalt, and you can also see 16 emblems of 16 republics of USSR. This building looks very monumental and festive, but it's actually a skeleton building covered with plaster and marble crump. During restoration works, two historical values were discovered in the central pavilion, and one of them is the high relief by Evgeny Vucetich, which is called Glory to the Soviet People, Peace Standard Barriers. Its scale is about 88 square meters and the depth is 73 centimeters. It depicts more than 1,500 people, different nationalities and different professions, marching in one eternal stream. They're holding flags and the central couple is holding a baby with the symbol of peace, white pigeon. You can also see profile of Lenin, and there were also three other profiles of Stalin, Engels and Marx, but they have been removed by the author. You can also see images of the iconic Soviet constructions, which were made in a technique of microrelief. One of the skyscrapers, Shukhov television tower, and Dnipro-Gres, which is the hydro power station. So the relief is made of plaster and tinted as bronze. Another art object which was found is an oil painting by the famous Soviet social realist artist Alexander Gerasimov. Its scale is about 7 on 11 meters, and it depicts the second meeting of collective farmers and shock workers in the process of arranging the exhibition. So it's an important historical moment for the exhibition. But because of the Stalin image, the painting was removed and it was lying in storage until 2014. So here are some photographs of the restoration process where you can actually see a scale of these two works. One of the most famous attractions of VDNH is located right after the central pavilion at Kolkhoz Square, which is the central square of the exhibition. It's called Friendship of Nations. In the middle of the composition you can see a giant golden sheaf made of different agriculture plants and round a lay of 16 girls representing 16 republics of USSR. So until 1956 there were 16 republics, including Karelian Finnish Republic, which lost its status within 2 years and became part of Russia. Each girl is dressed in a national clothes and holding a fruit or agriculture plants in her hand. Here are some photographs made during the restoration, and you can see that each sculpture was covered with a golden leaf, and in total about 5 kilograms of a golden leaf was used to gild all the statues. And that's how it looks during the night. This fountain can process about 1,200 liters of water per second, and we can also call it a dancing fountain because the height and directions of its streams is changing during an hour. One of my favorite pavilions is called Azerbaijan. It was built in 1939 and reconstructed in 1967. So the National Azerbaijani Exposition was replaced by the exposition of electronic technologies and informatics. The original facade, which was discovered in 2014, was widely decorated with Majolik, national ornament, and also Soviet symbols, red stars, hammer and sickle. Window frames are decorated with shebeke, which is a unique Azerbaijani technique of making a mosaic. And pieces of colored glass are attached to the wooden frame without any glue and nails, so it's hard jewelry work. The exposition is now dedicated to Azerbaijani culture, and you can see a lot of authentic objects from Azerbaijan, musical instruments, shebeke samples, photographs with famous sightseeing of Azerbaijan. Beautiful flower parterre is located right in the middle of the square with all historical pavilions and fountains. It has been fully restored and won the prestigious Moscow Restoration Award in 2017. The stone flower is the biggest fountain at the exhibition, and it was built after eponymous fairy tale The Stone Flower by the famous Russian writer Balashova. The central composition is decorated with small pieces of colored smalt to imitate precious and semi-precious stones. So this fountain is also one of the most powerful fountains at the exhibition, and it can process about 2000 liters per second. This is a restoration process of one of the historical pavilions, which is called Agriculture, former Ukrainian Socialist Republic. While entering the building, you can see two sculptures from 1939 symbolizing agriculture and industry. After the restoration, this pavilion turned into a center for Cyrillics, and the exposition is dedicated to a written language history. A lot of excursions, lectures, workshops are held here all year round. The last pavilion I would like to talk about is called Space. Former name is Mechanization and Electrification of Agriculture. It was built in 1939 in the shape of a hangar to demonstrate agriculture machines. But in 1954, the building was reconstructed, and it got its impressive facade and giant dome. The height of the dome is 60 meters, and it's about 40 meters in diameter. The model of spacecraft Vostok was installed in 1967, and at the same year, the pavilion was renamed Cosmos, which means space. First satellites, original Gagarin space capsule, and other space equipment were demonstrated inside of the space pavilion. So from the collapse of USSR until 2014, this building was also used as a giant marketplace, and people could buy plants, televisions, and clothes inside of the pavilion. Here are some images where you can see a space exposition and how this pavilion was transformed into a market area. In 2018, Modern Center for Cosmonautic and Aviation was opened inside of this space pavilion, and now it's one of the most popular museums and educational centers of the exhibition. A lot of exhibitions, lectures, public events, movie screenings are held here all year round. For example, Moscow Restoration Award was held in 2019. So after visiting museums and expositions, it's nice to have a walk in a pond area, which is called the Landscape Park. It's located behind the Space Pavilion, and it's a transition zone between very active Central Alley and Botanical Garden. The concept of the park was created by the famous French architect Michel Pinard, and his idea was to preserve the original historical landscape and to make it more convenient and accessible for visitors. One of my favorite locations in the landscape park is called Green Theater. It was built in 1939, so it's a historical object, and was restored and reopened in 2014. So the original architectural solution was to integrate an open-air theater to a surrounding landscape. Now the historical stage is equipped with high-tech steel constructions and modern lighting and sound system. So each summer season, the Green Theater hosts a lot of concerts, ballets, performances, movie screenings, and theater plays. If you like sports, there are also a lot of sports areas and sports activities in the landscape park. Most of the playgrounds are installed near the historical sports pavilion, so you can play football, basketball, indoor soccer, and do many other different kinds of sports. There is also all year round workout zone, and you can also rent a boat or do wakeboarding or just have a walk through the ecological trail. In 2015, VDNH got prestigious prize for the establishment of a modern sports cluster and the largest skating rink with the artificial surface. Skating is one of the favorite winter activities in Russia, so VDNH holds the largest skating rink. Its whole area is 60,000 square meters and 20,000 square meters of artificial ice. It can accommodate more than 4,000 people simultaneously. A lot of different public events are held at the territory of the rink, and we do guided tours. We celebrate New Year's, Russian spring holidays, which is called Maslenitsa, and even St. Valentine's Day. It's very important to say that a lot of events have a charity purpose, and the rink is also accessible for disabled people. So there are much more interesting at the exhibition, and I'm glad to invite you to visit VDNH, and I hope to see you all next summer season. So at the end of my presentation, I would like to thank you all for the attention, and I wish you a good day and take care.